Come on, let's get loud and proud. Menard! Outstanding. How are you?
Doing good. Doing good.
Man, how does this feel?
Good day to go racing.
Man, this is awesome.
Beautiful Kansas State, not too hot, not too cold, and sunshine for once.
I know. Last year, what year was freezing here?
It was cold last year, and we had bad luck with weather this year. You know, it's just been a lot of rain and chasing the weather a little bit. But again, beautiful day to race.
Hey, I gotta ask. I always just started out with, how's the car feel for today's race?
It's slippery for sure. The tracks getting wore out as we run, and you can move all over the track, which makes it a lot of fun for us riders. Very slippery though. You can fight both ends. You chase the front of the car, chase the back of the car. We made a couple of adjustments this morning for the race. Hopefully it's in the right direction. We'll find out in a couple hours. But I feel like we have a pretty good car. Start sixth, and we can race with them.
Do you think racing in the Nationwide helps you for the cup race today?
Yes and no. The racing part does for sure. I learned some things yesterday racing the Nationwide race that will definitely apply to today. It's the Saturday practices or the Friday practices where you're jumping back and forth a lot. That kind of messes you up. You kind of forget what car you're in half the time. But we had a really good Nationwide car. Learned some tire pressure stuff. Learned what the track's going to do, and we're going to use that today.
So is that stuff that just you learn, or does your crew chief as well learn during that race?
Yeah, Slugger Lavi, my cup crew chief, was sitting on the Nationwide box yesterday with Chris Carrier, who's the Nationwide crew chief. So he's understanding what we were doing yesterday to help the car. We were really tight yesterday, just plowing through the center and actually made a lot of adjustments, got the car really good at the end. So he knows what we did there. We played with tire pressure and
I know that you're really goal-oriented, and you set your goals beginning of the year. Is your year going as planned?
You know, we won a race, which, you know, that's...
That was a huge race. You say it like it's no big deal. You won Indy.
We won Indy. We've come close to winning a pole a few times. We've been on the front row a couple times, been qualifying really well, but we want to get that pole position. And, you know, we're not where we want to be, that's for sure. But we were in the hunt for the chase with the wild card and the way things worked out. We were in the hunt for that, which is one of our goals. But now we're sitting, I think, 22nd points, which has been a couple of months, so trying to bounce back.
So what goals are you setting for yourself for next year?
Well, we're going to finish out this year strong and see what we can learn for next year. But we'll sit down in the offseason and try to figure it out. But we want to be in contention for that chase spot, as everybody.
Paul, do you hang out with any of the other drivers? Just at the racetrack, or maybe even not at the racetrack, do you hang out with the drivers, or do you just you're like, listen, Johnny, when I'm done, I go home and I hang out with my boys and stuff.
We see all those drivers see each other every week, and we, you know, I always want to beat each other every week. So we're friendly towards each other, but there's not a lot of drivers that actually hang out with each other. The one guy that I do hang out with is Reedy Smith. We go in the offseason. Do some ski trips together and stuff, and our girlfriends are really good friends too, so we might go to a concert or something later in the season.
So what's that like, walking in to your stores like Menards and seeing big posters of you everywhere? I mean, you're a walking billboard now. Has that changed your lifestyle, like the way you feel, the way you think?
No, not at all. I mean, I'm a pretty low-key guy. I don't go up there, you know, flashing around or whatever, but you know, I go in the stores, we do our appearances, and I'm still active in the stores and in our, I'm the Senate Board of Directors, we have a meeting next week. So, you know, I'm pretty involved in the business side, and, you know, whatever they want to do to put up promotional stuff, it's up to the marketing team, but I'm still pretty active in the business side, yeah.
So what are you going to do on your time off? After the season's over, you're done, what is Paul Menard going to do? Where are you going to go for vacation? What are you going to do for the New Year's? I mean, what's that going
to
be like?
We're done on a Sunday night in Miami. I'm going to go home Monday to Wisconsin and do a couple days of deer hunting with my brothers. And then I fly back down to Florida for Regan Smith's wedding. We're both, Jen, my girlfriend, and I are both in his wedding on the, I think it's a Saturday after Miami. We'll do a bunch of back and forth, but I have a couple ski trips planned. I love skiing.
Now, do you ski or snowboard?
I do both, but I'm a lot better skier than I'm snowboarder. So I actually just bought a new pair of skis and anxious trying out. But yeah, I'm going west to, we're going to Jackson Hole in December in Wyoming. And over Christmas, New Year's, I'll be back home in Wisconsin, hopefully do some snowmobiling.
Awesome. I always wondered, last night I was thinking, I want to ask you a question that I've never asked you before. When you first come into this business and you have a number in mind, do you own that number, or does the person that owned the car own the number?
NASCAR owns the numbers.
Oh, really? So you can't? It's not yours.
If you, for number 27, we had to go through an approval process with NASCAR. And I think Bill Davis, I believe, owned the number before Richard got it. So he just had to go through an approval process. But there's some numbers available, and they're pretty easy to work with as far as if you want an available number. But if somebody already has history with that number, it's tough to get it.
So how many tires do you get? How many sets of tires do you get, like, for today's race? Do you know?
Well, I know we have five sets for Friday and Saturday for practice and qualifying. And for the race, I think it's 10. It's either 10, 11, or 12, somewhere around there. And I'll talk to Chris Sherwood, my tire guy, but hopefully they're good at one.
Not that you ever get worked up, because like you said, you're a pretty low-key guy. I can't even imagine you being worked up. But if you ever did get worked up during a race, who's that one person that can come over your earphones and calm you down and say, Paul, you know it's going to be okay. Get back in the game. Put your head back in the game. Who's that one person?
I'd like to say Slugger, but I'm doing the calming down on him most of the time. He's a pretty wound-up guy, but probably between Slugger and Stevie Reese, my spotter, we talk through things well. I don't really get worked up that much, but sometimes we all get pissed off at times. There's guys that help you out with that.
Is there any type of racing that you would love to try? Like, you know, just like sit there and think to yourself, you know what? I can go do this right now and then actually go do it.
Well, I don't know if I can do it, but I'd love to drive a sprint car. Sprint car, a little dirt track somewhere, and I've driven a lot of different types of cars in my life. I've been fortunate to do that, but a sprint car I've never done, and I'd love to.
If you, like, every great athlete has an incredible coach. And growing up, I mean, your career has started down here and now is way up here. But who has been some of your coaches throughout your career?
I was big into sports when I was a kid. Played a lot of football, played a lot of hockey. Tried playing baseball, wasn't very good at that. But had different coaches in different aspects of sports, and they helped along the way. But as far as racing goes, we had three brothers back home, the Burgess brothers, Pete, Andy, and Paul. And they were very active in go-karting and ice racing and some sports car races, and they kind of took it under their wing.
Did you say ice racing?
Ice racing, yeah.
So what is that? No kidding, I know it's on ice, but I mean, do they actually have like...
Yeah, it's the International Ice Racing Association, IIRA, is a series. They run Minnesota, Wisconsin, parts of Canada. It's full-size sedans, cars, you know, two-door, four-door cars, and we take a brand new tire, street tire, grind down the rubber, and hold in 160 studs per wheel. So it's really good grip. You know, it's kind of consistency of driving on loose gravel. Anywhere from a mile and a half to 5 mile road courses. We run on Lake Superior and bays of Lake Superior. We've had ice flows, take away part of the racetrack. It's a lot of fun. It's pretty great.
So on your time off, you get done racing on Sunday, you fly home, or went not back to the race shop, what do you do to de-stress yourself from the weekend?
Not a whole lot, it's kind of right back to work. Mondays are kind of recovery day, type of number reports and stuff, and work out with my trainers Tuesday, Thursday, go up to the shop Wednesdays, and we'll throw in some appearances throughout the week, depending on the schedule. Every week's a little bit different, but I don't have really a set routine, I just kind of go with it. Like I said, everyone's different.
So, I mean, this schedule's brutal. How do you stay mentally and physically fit?
You don't have time to really sit back and let yourself go. You're always doing something that's very active. We race 38 weekends out of the year. And then on the off week, like I said, I go skiing and snowmobiling and just do a bunch of different things. So you don't really have time to get lethargic, I guess. You're always on the go.
Okay, one last question, they're saying time's up. When you have time to watch TV, what shows do you watch? A fan wanted me to ask you that, and I'm like, that's a great question.
I love Modern Family. That's a great show. Outside of that, I don't really watch a whole lot of TV. I don't really watch the NASCAR shows. I watch the Speed Center. Then a lot of course, Sunday night, Monday night football. And if we have a Sunday off, Sunday afternoon football, that's probably it.
okay, just, and I know you gotta go, but who are you voting for when it comes to baseball for the World Series?
Milwaukee Brewers. We were testing Phoenix this week, and I haven't been to a baseball game in probably 5 years. And we got tickets to go to see the Diamondbacks and Brewers play. And of course, it was the first game the Brewers lost in the playoffs, but they bounced back. But I'm not a really big baseball guy, but you know, the games were a lot of fun. I actually got into a lot more than I thought.
Ladies and gentlemen, Paul Menard.